Roll out the holly, lift up the tree, for my spirit falls again. Lift up the holly. We may be rushing things, but deck the halls again down. For we need a little Christmas, right this very minute. Hands in the window, carols at the spinet. Yes, we need a little happy, happy ever after. We need a little Christmas now. Well, you guys are not in the Christmas spirit at all. You guys are not in the Christmas spirit at all. Oh my goodness. I want to talk today about these stories that we have for them, rich in God's love and rich in human endeavors. In our first reading today from the book of Exodus, we hear about the Israelites trapped in the land of Egypt for 400 years. They were enslaved by their captors. They lived and endured under incredibly harsh conditions. They were forced into manual labor. They were forced into practices that most humans would be seen as subhuman. And in the midst of their treachery and their tragedy, after 400 years of this treatment, those ancient Israelites must have felt as if God didn't care. They must have wondered, did God remember who they were? They must have been concerned with, did God really care about their plight? And then we have this Bible character, Moses, a man who as an infant was saved from the water Nile, and then kicked out of the only home that he ever knew, forced out into the desert where he knew not God. He never knew who this God of Israel was. And standing in the desert, he sees a burning bush up on a mountain, and he approaches that bush. I imagine that Moses, just being a normal human being, would have wondered, who was this God, the God that the Israelites claimed created and fashioned the cosmos? And how could I, being kicked out of my own home, ever be worthy of knowing this God? And Moses must have wondered, did God really care? Did God really love me? Moses must have wondered, how do I even get close to a God so great? Truth is, both the Israelites and Moses, well, they need a little Christmas, need to hear a new song, need to know for sure that they don't belong. Oh, yes, they need to hear a song sing. Gospel changes everything. They need a little Christmas now. You see, God responded to the Israelites, and God responded to Moses. God shared with the Israelites, I have always known you, and I have always loved you. I have heard the cries of your distress because of the harsh treatment that you've been facing. And I will send someone among you who will lead you out of Egypt. And for Moses, God responded by saying, I am the Lord God that you sought. And you too are a loved and precious child of mine, even though you never even knew me. You are worthy to be loved. And I will use you to advance my kingdom here on earth. And oh, by the way, Moses, you don't need to find me, because I always know where you're at. And I will always be with you. And soon enough, both Moses and the ancient Israelites came to know God on incredibly personal and intimate levels as God brought the Israelites out of captivity and walked with them all to lead the way. Now our gospel writer, Luke, shares with us a story about shepherds. And the only way for this story really to make sense to us living in the year of our Lord 2018 is to think of workers in our workforce who seem to be substandard. Maybe for some of us, that's migrant, maybe even illegal immigrants that come into our lands and pluck fruit from trees. Or maybe from where I grew up, it's the people who worked in the mushroom farms, They were considered dirty, and they do work that no one else would want to do. These shepherds were seen like that in their society. No one really wanted to be around them because, quite frankly, no one really cared too much about them except their personal families. I'm sure for these shepherds, they wondered whether or not if they lived or whether they died, whether anyone would notice. And I'm positive the shepherds would have felt like they were not important enough for God to spend any time with. And they would have wondered whether or not they were even worthy to share a piece of good news from God. Luke also brings a new character into the story by bringing us a young girl between the ages of 13 and 15. And I'm sure this young girl, like any young girl at the age of 15, never thought that she was very special. She probably never thought that God would use her in any special or particular way, never thought that she could be worthy to carry a message from God into the world, let alone carry the Son of God in her very womb. In other words, for people like both the shepherds and our young girl Mary, what they really needed, well, they needed a little Christmas. They needed to hear a new song. They needed to know for sure that they belonged in the kingdom of God. They needed a little Christmas. They needed to hear the whole world sing that God's love does change everything. And indeed, the rest is history. You and I know that God's love did change everything. For the shepherds, an angel was sent, and a multitude of angels. And the shepherds would be the first people in the world to hear of the birth of the Christ child proclaimed. They would be the ones to usher in the proclamation of God's good news to all the people of this world. And Mary, that young 13-year-old girl, well, for the rest of time, until time infinite, the world would remember her faithfulness. The way she stood with God, the way God used her as an instrument of God's grace within the world. A gift given to her from God that would forever change the face of the earth. You know, this week in the United Proclamation of the Gospel, we shared Vacation Bible School. And there were 63 children from across Bethlehem that came to share at Vacation Bible School. There were 33 adult volunteers there, each using their hands, their gifts, their talents to bring God's love into the life of those children. For you see, I think out of those 63 children that were there, there were probably some of them that already, even at their young ages, are taught that they're not good, that they are not worthy. That they're either too tall, too small, too fat, too skinny, too much red hair, not smart enough, or there's something the matter with them. Because that's the world that they grow up in. That's the world they live in. And I'm sure out of all of those 63 children that were there, there were children that don't think that God would ever use them in particularly special ways, that they're not special enough for God to share a message of hope, peace and love of the world. And I'm sure that in that group of 63 people, that there were children among them that don't necessarily live in the best home environment, that don't know what love and nurturing really looks like. You know what those kids needed? They needed a little bit of Christmas. They needed to know that they belong. They needed to know that they are loved and precious children of God, worthy of love and faithfulness and all the gifts that surround that. And you know what? God sent them 33 adult workers. God sent them 33 people who shared their gifts and their talents with those children, who gave their arms to hug them, who used their mouths to share a word of God's peace and their love, who used their hands to nourish them with good food, who helped them sing and dance and play, And all of a sudden, the walls between those 63 children, each who come from different homes and different walks of life, shattered and fell. And suddenly, these children knew where they belonged. They knew that in the house of God, that they would always be welcome. They needed a little Christmas, and they got a little Christmas. And now the story comes to you and I. The story that God's love does. Oh my goodness. I'm dying up here. That's all I got. Do you feel the passion? God's love
changes everything.
Yes, the story now comes to you. The story comes to you, and you may not feel as if you're particularly worthy to share a message of God's love in the world in which we live. You yourself may wonder whether or not God even hears your voice, let alone will act on your voice. You may yourself wonder whether or not you should even be part of God's kingdom on earth. But you know what you all need? You need a little Christmas. You need to know that because God says you belong, that you belong. And because God created all humanity belongs in the kingdom of God, worshiping with God's children to the glory of God's name. You need to be using your gifts, your arms, your legs, your voices, your special God-given talents with the rest of the world to share a message of love. That in spite of everything that the world throws at us, that the one who formed and fashioned all of creation is a God of love. A God who desires that all people know that they belong. And so, we'll leave this place proclaiming it from the mountain above that God came to this world and God's love changes everything. We'll proclaim it from the places that we work, allowing people to see through our lives that God's love changed our life and can change your life. We'll proclaim the coming kingdom of God through every action, every word, and everything that we think and do until all of creation knows that God's love is meant for them and that God's love really does
change everything.
Amen.